there, Rebel Nation. Your Rebel Nation crew here, Cassie Soto, Mark Anderson. After UNLV suffers its first loss in the TJ Otzelberger era, Mark, not only just a regular loss, but an overtime loss, falling 60-56 to Kansas State. Well, before we get into it, Mark, let's hear what Coach TJ Otzelberger and his guys had to say.
Really impressive to hold a Big 12 champion program. We have a lot of respect for, to 16 first half points. Felt like the thing that we need to correct is that start to the second half just not been great to us. Got to get better there. Got to get better executing late. Overall, happy with the competitive spirit that our guys played with. We knew it was going to be a physical match. I think we were, you know, outsized at most positions, but the fight that our guys played with, I was really proud of.
We knew that they probably were going to make their run. We should have, stayed steady, continuously playing that hard-nosed defense. I feel like we kind of got, we lost our identity where we hang our hat on, which is on defense, and we continuously try to play offense, and then we slipped up, let them get a couple buckets, and that's how the game got kind of close. But, even more so, I feel like in the second half, we kind of knew what they were going to do. We had them on their heels. They was trying to attack us each and every play down, getting to the basket, because the three is one falling, and we got to go into the second half continuously focusing and not letting guys get to the paint to make plays.
We said that this would be the first real test of this team, and it proved to be just that.
It was, and they had every chance to win the game. Had a shot at the end of regulation. Can't ask for much more than that. At 7-point lead at halftime, probably should have won the game in a lot of ways. TJ Osberg, you could tell at the end of the game, was disappointed. So many close chances that got away from them. That you can look back at any number of plays that would have made the difference. So, but yeah, they played what could be a really good team, really tough, and something to build on.
Well, Amari Hardy really stepped up for his team. He had 27 of those 56 points for the Rebels. Where did that hot hand come from for him?
You could see it early. He had 15 in the first half, and he was shooting with confidence, and he just felt, it was one of those nights where he felt like anything, almost anything could go in. And he took advantage of it. And he was really the one guy who was shooting that well. Elijah Mitchell has his moments too, but he was really the only guy.
TJ Otzelberger said in the press conference, Mark, that they really have been emphasizing on defense. Right. So if there were any offensive mistakes, he does take credit for that. What happened there, especially late and in overtime? Offensively, they couldn't really put it together.
Yeah, Kansas State contested everything throughout the game, and you knew they would. That's the type of style they play. Real physical game. The officials let them play at times. Other times they didn't. And so UNLV knew it had to win this game with defense, and I think that's his approach all season anyway. He doesn't have the shooters he wants yet. Geno Antonio is really the consistent outside shooter he has, maybe Amari Hardy at times. So they're going to have to win games with defense. And so that's as he mentioned today, rebounding, defense, travel. They go on the road for two games. So they're going to need both there.
Now, you mentioned the two-game road trip coming up for the Rebels, the first of the season. How are they going to face off against Cal and UCLA next? What do you think they need to do to fix up there?
They need to get back in the offensive rhythm they found early on in the exhibition and the opener. They need more of that. They were taken completely out of that today. They probably won't face a defensive team this good all season again, so they'll probably get more into that. They got to keep the defense going. They got to keep the rebounding going. They keep those two going. They have every chance to win at Cal, and they should at least give UCLA a good game.
All right, well, that'll do it for us, Mark. Once again, the Rebels are on the road at Cal and at UCLA. We'll see how they fare their first road trip of the season. For Mark Anderson, I'm Cassie Soto. Thanks for watching Rebel Nation.